وَأُزْلِفَتِ الْجَنَّةُ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. And paradise will be brought near that day to the righteous. When? On the day that the people are resurrected, on the day of judgment, when wealth and children are not going to help, when only qalbin salim is going to help. On that day, what's going to happen? Uzlifat. Just as the word azlafna, zayd anfa, to bring near, to draw close. So wa uzlifatil jannatu. Paradise is going to be brought near to who? Lil muttaqeen. Why? So that they can see it. So that they can enter it quickly. Wa burrizatil jahimu. And on the other hand, hellfire will be brought forth. For who? Lil ghaween, for the deviators. Burrizat ba-ra-zai. Buruz. And buruz is to come into view. So burrizat, it will be brought into view. It will be exposed, so that it becomes visible to them, so that they can see it clearly. وَبُرِّزَتِ الْجَحِيمُ لِلْغَاوِينَ. And غَاوِين, plural of غَاوِي. Who is غَاوِي? One who is in غَي, who is in deviation, who is deviated from the right way. So hellfire will be shown to them. They'll be made to see the hellfire. وَقِيلَ لَهُمْ. And it will be said to them, أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْبُدُونَ. Where is it that you used to worship? Where are all those beings whom you used to worship, whom you thought were your gods? Ibrahim alayhi salam asked them, what is it that you worship? Have you thought about what you worship? Can they benefit you? Can they harm you? Not at all. Who can really benefit you? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So on the day of judgment, the people who adhere to the worship of the idols, they'll be asked in reproach, that where are those beings whom you used to worship? مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Besides Allah. هَلْ يَنصُرُونَكُمْ. Do they help you today? أَوْ يَنتَصِرُونَ. Or can they at least help themselves? يَنتَصِرُونَ from انتصار. And انتصار is to assist oneself, to defend oneself. So where are they today? Can they help you today? Can they take you out of trouble today? This hellfire that you can see, can they save you from it? Or at least can they save themselves from it? No, they cannot. If they cannot help themselves, then how can they help you? فَكُبْكِبُوا فِيهَا. So they'll be overturned into the hellfire. Whom? They? وَالْغَاوُونَ. And the deviators. كُبْكِبُوا. كُبْكِبُوا from the root letters? كَافْ بَا بَا. كَبْ. كَبَّ الْإِنَا is to put a container upside down. What does it mean? To put a container upside down. So it gives a sense of overturning something. And kabba fulanan is to push someone, to throw someone on their face. So it is as though to push someone from behind so that they fall on their face, upside down. Not on their back, but on their face, upside down. So kubakibu, they'll be toppled over. They'll be turned upside down and thrown into the hellfire. Who? Both. Whom? The asnam, the idols that they used to worship, and along with them, والغاوون, and the deviators as well, meaning those who worship them. So what do we learn from this? That on the day of judgment, after the hisab, after the accountability, what's going to happen? Jannah will be brought near. So that the distance between Jannah and the people of Jannah is shortened. So that they can enter Jannah very quickly. And on the other hand, what's going to happen to the people of hellfire? That they'll be made to see the hellfire. And they'll be reproached again and again. That where are those beings whom you used to worship? Can they help you? Can they assist you? Not at all. And then they'll be thrown into the hellfire, face down, upside down, overturned. Who? The idols, as well as those who worship them. And they'll be thrown down from where? From the sirat. Who else will be thrown into the hellfire? وَجُنُودُ إِبْلِيسَ أَجْمَعُونَ. And the soldiers of Iblis altogether. Junud, plural of junt. Who are the soldiers of Iblis? Those who follow him. Those who are obedient to him. Those who are misguided themselves, and they also misguide others. جُنُودُ إِبْلِيسَ أَجْمَعُونَ. Altogether. No matter how many they may be, no matter how numerous they may be, all of them are going to be thrown into the hellfire. In Surah Al-Hijr, ayah 42-44, we learn that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Iblis that إِنَّ عِبَادِي لَيْسَ لَكَ عَلَيْهِمْ سُلْطَانٍ. My servants, you have no authority over them. إِلَّا مَنِ اتَّبَعَكَ مِنَ الْغَاوِينَ. Except for those people who follow you of the غاوين. وَإِنَّ جَهَنَّمَ لَمَوْعِدُهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ. And indeed hellfire, it is their promised place altogether. And don't think the hellfire is too small. No. لَهَا سَبْعَةُ أَبْوَابِ. It has 7 doors, 7 gates. And according to others, 7 levels. لِكُلِّ بَابٍ مِّنْهُمْ جُزْءٌ مَقْسُومٌ. For every gate is of them a portion that is designated. قَالُوا. They will say. Who will say? Those people who worship the idols. They will say, وَهُمْ فِيهَا يَخْتَصِمُونَ. While all of them are disputing therein. يختصمون from اختصام. And اختصام is to dispute with one another, to quarrel with one another. So who will be quarreling in the hellfire? All these people that have been mentioned over here. The غاوين, those who are deviated. The أصنام, those who are worshipped besides Allah. And also جنود إبليس, the troops of إبليس. All of them will be disputing with one another. What will they say? What will the deviator say? Those who followed, those who worship the idols, those who follow the footsteps of shaitan, they will say, Tallahi, by Allah, in kunna lafi dalalim mubin. Indeed we were in manifest error. What was wrong with us? What were we doing? By Allah, we were clearly wrong. We were clearly in error. In this dunya, they don't acknowledge. When they're made to see the truth, when they're made to realize the truth, they don't admit, they don't accept. But on that day, they will acknowledge the truth. إِذْ نُسَوِّيكُمْ. When we used to equate you, بِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, with the Lord of the worlds. نُسَوِّي, from the root letters, سِينْ وَاوِيَا. سَوَّى يُسَوِّي تَسْوِيَا, to make equal. So when we used to make you equal to the Lord of the worlds, when we considered you equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we worshipped you, we were clearly in error. When we committed shirk, we were clearly wrong. But we did not use our mind. وَمَا أَضَلَّنَا. And no one misguided us. إِلَّا الْمُجْرِمُونَ. Except the criminals. Even then they will not realize it was their fault. Again, who will they blame? Others. Other people led us astray. Who led us astray? الْمُجْرِمُونَ. The criminals. And who are the criminals? Our leaders, our predecessors, our forefathers. Because in the dunya, whenever they were asked, why do you worship these idols? What was the answer? وَجَدْنَا أَبَاءَنَا كَذَلِكَ يَفْعَلُونَ. This is how we found our forefathers. This is what they used to do. Therefore, we follow them in their footsteps. So, وَمَا أَضَلَّنَا إِلَّا الْمُجْرِمُونَ. We learn in Surah Al-Ahzab, ayah 67, that the people of hellfire, they will say, وَقَالُوا رَبَّنَا إِنَّا أَطَعْنَا سَادَتَنَا وَكُبَرَاءَنَا فَأَضَلُّونَ السَّبِيلَ. And they will say, our Lord, indeed we obeyed our masters and our dignitaries. Those people who were above us, our dignitaries, our leaders, our predecessors, we followed them and they led us astray from the right way. فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ. So now we have no intercessors. No one can come and intercede for us. No one will come and intercede for us. Request that we should be saved from the punishment. وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ. And nor a devoted friend. We have no one to come and intercede for us. And at the same time we have no devoted friend even who will come and request for us. If you notice, Shafi'een is plural. And Sadiq and Hamim, singular. Why? That Sadiq and Hamim, not even one friend, not even one sincere, devoted, loyal friend from the dunya that we used to have, not even one of them will come to defend us. Sadiq is used for someone who is Sadiq fi wuddihi, someone who is very sincere in his love. Someone who shows that he's very, very sincere to you. Who proves his friendship to be true. So in the dunya, all those friends who proved their friendship to be true, they were very, very loyal to us. They supported us in everything. Today, we don't even have one of them coming to help us. And Hamim, from Hamimim, Humma, it's used for heat. Hamim, that which is very hot, also used for boiling hot water, but it's also used for a very close friend. The one who boils in his love for you, in his sincerity and loyalty for you. That if somebody says anything against you, he boils in anger. وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ Not even one sincere friend will come and protect us. Over here, a scene from the Day of Judgment is being described. That when the criminals are hurled, one on top of the other into hellfire, كُبُكِبُ فِيهَا One on top of the other, what will happen? The people of hellfire, they will begin to quarrel and dispute with one another. This is mentioned here, and it's also mentioned elsewhere in the Quran. For example, in Surah Al-A'raf, Ayah 38, we learn, قَالَ دُخُلُوا فِي أُمَمٍ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ مِنَ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنْسِ فِي النَّارِ كُلَّمَا دَخَلَتْ أُمَّةٌ لَعَنَتْ أُخْتَهَا Every time a people will enter hellfire, its sister, meaning the following nation, or the preceding nation, what will it do? What will it do? لَعَنَتْ It's going to curse. Today what happens? People are very proud of their friendship. People are very proud of what they do. People are very, very proud of their wrong ways. They're very proud to be followers of so-and-so, friends of so-and-so, adherents of so-and-so, owners of such-and-such. But on that day, all these connections will get cut off. And all these friendships will turn into enmity. That people, instead of supporting one another in that time of pain and hardship and hellfire, what will they do? Rebuke one another, blame one another, argue with one another, dispute with one another. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that الْأَخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ That close friends on that day, some of them will be enemies to one another. Why? Because they led one another astray. إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ Except for those people who have taqwa. What did we learn earlier about Ibrahim a.s.? He recognized who his enemy was. And he recognized who was really his friend. He recognized that anything that took him away from the worship of Allah, that took him towards punishment, was what? His enemy. No matter how innocent it appears to be, no matter how harmless it appears to be, but in reality, what is it? Enemy. But unfortunately, we see this today, but we overlook it. We know who our enemies are. We know that perhaps from among our friends, there are those who make us say things that are very wrong, that make us do things that are very wrong, but still just to please them. Just to look cool, just to look good, just to be famous. We continue with these friendships and we keep on doing wrong things, one after the other. But on that day, these friendships will not bring any benefit to a person. They'll be a source of great regret for him. Ya waylata laytani lam attakhidh fulanan khalila. I wish I had not taken so and so as my friend. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Sad, Ayah 64, إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ لَحَقٌ تَخَاصُمُ أَهْلِ النَّارِ Indeed, that is truth. What is the truth? The quarreling of the people of hellfire. Today they are together. Today they might show that they are close to one another, but on the Day of Judgment, they are going to fight with one another. You will notice that even in dunya, people who may appear to be very close to each other, what happens? They end up fighting with one another when? When they suffer from some loss. Or if there is a conflict of interest. People may be very close to one another previously, but as soon as there is a conflict, as soon as they suffer some loss, what happens? Immediately they start fighting with one another. All their friendship goes down the drain. It's finished. The loss that people will suffer in the hereafter, in hellfire, is greater than any other loss. So all those friendships, all those close connections will be finished. All those claims of love and friendship will be abolished that day, will come to an end that day. فَلَوْ So if only, أَنَّ لَنَا كَرَّةً, if only we had a return. كَرَّة is a return, meaning another chance. If we only had another chance, to do what? To go back to the dunya. فَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, then we would be of the believers. If we only have one more chance, we will become sincere believers. In Surah Al-A'raf, Ayah 53, we learn that the people will say, أَوْ نُرَدُّ فَنَعْمَلَ غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلُ. If only we could be sent back, we will do deeds other than what we used to do before. But is anyone going to be sent back? Is anyone going to be given another chance? No way. Because even if people are given another chance, what do we learn? In Surah Al-An'am 28, وَلَوْ رُدُّوا لَعَادُوا لِمَا نُهُوا عَنْهُ وَإِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. If they are sent back, they will go back to their ways. They're liars. Because if you think about it, even in this dunya, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes us see who is our enemy, who is our friend. He makes us see that. He makes us realize that. That those same friends, because of them we get into trouble. We end up failing our exams. We end up doing things that are inappropriate. We get into trouble. From our parents, from our teachers, from our loved ones. But what happens? If we have truly learned a lesson, we will change our ways. But those people who do not take a lesson, what happens? They go back to those same friends. They go on doing the same things that they used to do before. They do not learn a lesson from even the greatest loss, from even the greatest harmful consequences. So if a person does not learn in this dunya, if he says that he has learned in the hereafter, he's not going to be given another chance. إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ. Indeed, in that, there is surely a sign. But still, وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. But still, most of them are not believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us again and again. Don't move on until you take a lesson from this. What is the lesson that we learn from this? From the story of Ibrahim alayhi salam, from the description of the Day of Judgment. What do we learn? Think about it. What ayah is there in this incident, in this description? Whatever you think is close to you today, it will leave you tomorrow. Whether it's your wealth, or it's your children, or it's your wrong friends, they will leave you tomorrow. Unless and until you have a qalb and salim. Because if you have a qalb and salim, then your wealth and children, how will you use them? In the way of Allah. Your friendships, what will they be for? For the sake of Allah. And these are a source of benefit. What else do we learn? That we are not to follow everything blindly. Just because somebody called us to do something, doesn't mean we have to listen to them. Unless obviously they're calling us to Quran and Sunnah, something that is of the deen, that we have to accept and follow. But anything other than that, don't follow a person blindly. Don't follow anything blindly. Use your mind that Allah has given. What else? That we must recognize who, what is our enemy. It could be a place, it could be a thing, it could be a person, it could be an action. What is our enemy? What is it that distracts me from Allah, from preparing for my akhirah? What is it that damages my heart? You understand? Qalb in Salim is what? Safe and sound heart, free of defects. What is it that damages my heart? What else? That arguing, ikhtisam, is a quality of who? The people of hellfire. So we should stay away from such behavior. And well-wishing is the quality of the people of Jannah. Learn from your mistakes now so we don't regret later. So, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَةٌ وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. Why is this said? That despite the fact that people see this ayah, despite the fact that people realize the ayah, still they don't change. Still their actions don't change. وَمَا كَانَ أَكْثَرُهُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. But still, Allah is so generous. وَإِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَهُ الْعَزِيزِ. He is mighty. Against who? Against those who are arrogant, those who are proud. And He is also Al-Rahim at the same time. Towards those who are truthful, those who have well-wishing, those who do good. We listen to the recitation of these ayah. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.